We want to welcome you as new members to Osher at Carnegie Mellon University. Let me explain the artwork you are looking at. I wanted something that was uniquely Osher at Carnegie Mellon. These images are from photographs I took, represent the teaching, learning, and socialization aspects of our Osher program. It does so in the spirit of Carnegie Mellon grad Andy Warhol. The image may or may not be important, however, the process is. I have never had any formal training in any of the skills needed to create this. I took my first watercolor course at Osher at the age of 70. Subsequently, I have taken Osher courses in drawing, photography, Photoshop, and Apple iMovie. Osher has not only given me the skills to attempt this project, but more importantly, Osher has given me the courage to do this project. At the upper left-hand corner of the drawing, you will see our benefactor, Andrew Carnegie. In the lower blue panel, at the right-hand side, you will see our benefactor, Bernard Osher. For the national conference, we were asked to make a 4-second movie introducing our organization. Do you know how difficult it is to make an exactly 4-second movie?
Hello from Carnegie Mellon University.
We are people just like you. You are now one of 2,400 members of this organization, with over 500 volunteers helping to run it. This is our current leadership team. Myself as president, John Olmsted, vice president, Gloriana St. Clair, secretary, and she was the past dean of the library systems, Carl Honenbaum, treasurer, Jan Davis, past president, and Lynn Decker, executive director. Amy Burkett, Vice Provost for Education at Carnegie Mellon University, is our university liaison. She is our advisor, mentor, and our major advocate to the university leadership team. OSHA? Osher? Well, what is it? If you walk into a manufacturing facility and they think you said OSHA, you may scare them to death. In Hebrew, Osher means happiness. Osher, or Osher Lifelong Learning Institute, OLLI, is a group of independent organizations at 119 colleges and universities in over 290 cities and towns throughout the United States. They all offer non-credit courses to over 150,000 seasoned adults. These institutes are made possible in part by generous grants from the Bernard Osher Foundation. Carnegie Mellon University has received over $2 million from the Osher Foundation to support our program. We receive the earnings from these grants. Osher at Carnegie Mellon is a gathering of people eager to enrich their lives by attending non-credit peer-led classes in an academic creative atmosphere at an outstanding university. Osher at CMU is unlike most Osher programs in that we are an independent, all-volunteer run program with a self-supported paid administrative staff. Most other Osher institutes are part of the host university's continuing education department. At Carnegie Mellon, we are affiliated with the university as a 401(c) nonprofit corporation. We are not part of the university. Osher is responsible for its own management and governance and enjoys a very positive relationship with the faculty and administration. Our mission is to continually to enhance this relationship. Osher has a symbiotic relationship with the university. Many of our members are alumni of CMU, and many of our instructors are active or retired professors from the university. Osher at Carnegie Mellon is the second largest traditional program in the country. However, it is viewed as the premier institute among all those offered. It is the largest Osher program in one central campus location. Due to the volunteer nature of Osher at Carnegie Mellon, we offer more variety and a greater number of classes than most other programs, but it is at a significantly lower cost to the members. Osher at CMU will be celebrating 24 years on campus soon. You may ask, how did Osher at CMU get started? In 1992, at a chance dinner meeting, the director of alumni relations and a recent master's degree recipient, at the age of 67, I may add, happened to be seated together. At that chance meeting, the idea for an institute for learning in retirement was formed. From this seed, 41 members started what is to be named the Academy for Lifelong Learning, or AL, at the university. The organization was given office space in the basement of the alumni building and the use of a dedicated classroom. Within 10 years, the program grew to 825 members, with 500 on the waiting list to become members. The program had reached its capacity in terms of space to hold classes and was then offering 140 classes per year. Throughout the succeeding years, all grew at a modest but continuing growth rate. However, in 2007, something significant occurred. All was approached by the OSHA Foundation and was offered a $100,000 grant to assist in expanding the program. With this change, the program was enabled to expand the membership to serve today's 2,400 members, with yet still 1,000 on the waiting list. Today, we offer in excess of 500 courses annually to our members, covering a wide number of subject matters. Due to classroom restraints, we rent additional facilities throughout the Oakland Shadyside area. We offer a wide range of categories, 34 in total. Of those categories, music, history, drama, arts, and exercise are the most prevalent and popular courses we offer. OSHA members have a variety of backgrounds, with education, business, and medical being the most prevalent. 67% of our members are within 5 miles of campus. An amazing 53% are within, quote, walking distance or within 2 miles of campus. At our age, that may not quite be walking distance, but the closeness of our population to the campus means we are truly a CMU community. Carnegie Mellon University is one of the world's premier universities. Pittsburgh is the only city in the United States with two OSHA organizations literally next door to each other. We have more OSHA members than any city in the United States. OSHA and its members also support the university by actively participating in research projects at the university. Studies on the effect of aging of the brain, memory, products design as it relates to the elderly, and we also support the university's efforts in food drives and film festivals. The undergraduates see our members going to class, using the computer labs, and checking out materials from the library. Members enjoy being audiences for the music performances, hearing talks and graduate student seminars in the humanities, and engaging in robotic club experiments. We are a dynamic organization, open up for new ideas all the time. New this year, we are hosting foreign students for our Thanksgiving meal. Also, we have now special interest groups. We have one patron of the arts, bridge, dining out, anything you wish to form, such as skiing, hiking, book clubs. You form the group and we'll help you announce the activities for your special interest group. OSHA at CMU is one of the state-of-the-art programs in the country. We are using modern computer registration, classroom scheduling, and catalog production systems in our day-to-day operations. OSHA at CMU is driven to success, in a great part because of the outstanding reputation of our university. Unlike most institutes, our OSHA program instructors volunteer their time to teach for OSHA at Carnegie Mellon. Other institutes pay their instructors. Volunteerism is a cornerstone of our success. 65% of our members are 70 years of age or older. We have at least 5 members over 95 years of age. One of them, I'm told, is taking Zumba lessons. The moral of the data is, keep learning to keep aging. This year's class is the largest first-year class ever. The significant thing to know about our organization is that 20% or almost 500 members have been in this program for 10 years or more. This speaks to the viability and excellence of the program. OSHA and Carnegie Mellon University, partners in learning. Hopefully you all know or will know about the famous fence at Carnegie Mellon University and the fact that it has to be painted after midnight. Well, that's after our bedtime hours.
Don't fence me in. Let me ride through the wide open country that I love. Don't fence me in. Let me be by myself in the evening breeze. Listen to the murmur of the cottonwood trees. Send me off forever, but I ask you please, don't fence me in. Just turn me loose. Let me straddle my old saddle underneath the western skies.
That's all, folks.